Guys, you're welcome once again to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how I creatively edited this image. This is not a skin retouching video, but this is to show you how I creatively added backgrounds and textures and give this picture the overall creative feel that you actually saw it look like in the final image from what I posted on Instagram. So without wasting so much time, I'm going to be getting straight into it. But before that, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, kindly hit the subscribe button and also share this video, turn on post notifications so when I post a video like this, you'll be the first to know. So straight to it. So this is an already edited version of this image we'll be working on today. And the first thing I did at this point, I love this image, looked pretty good. I already did the skin work and I already did some camera raw grading from my preset pack that I have on my store. So the next thing I needed to do in this image was just to make it look more like it, look more artistic and look more nice, like I actually worked on. So the first thing I'm going to be doing here is simple. So what I did first was that I already have a folder where I used, where I put all the resources I'll be needing to edit this image. So the first thing I'm going to be doing here will be that I'm going to be creating a mask before I start adding my textures. And what do I mean by that? I'm going to be coming to my filter, sorry, to my select. I'm going to be hitting subject. So it's going to select the subject. So now that it has selected it from the background, you would see that there are still some little areas I really want it to select everything. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come to my polygonal lasso tool, click on the add selection panel and do this. I'm going to just click and just, when you're doing yours, you just have to be very careful with this. I'm just going to do this as fast as I can. It doesn't waste too much time, so I'm going to delete here. So I'm going to go like this. Yeah, so it's going to go as far as coming here. But I don't want to. So when you're doing it, you can pretty much take your time. So you can see I've added this to selection. So my image looks well selected like this. So the next thing I'm going to be doing is just going to be hitting the hair mask button. So when I hit that, it's going to create the mask. That is, it's taking her out of the background. So I'm going to drop this and I'm going to now go to my documents, locate the resources. I think I tagged here. Then I'm going to be bringing in this texture. Gonna turn that in and yeah, I'm going to be turning it like this. Hit the shift button to make it easy and I'll use the option key or the alt to enlarge it like this. Good, and I hit the enter. So here we have our texture already on our image, and the next thing I'm going to be doing here, it will be changing my blending mode to soft light. So now you can see that this is before and after. You can see that our background now looks very much textured, but there's something wrong here. I do not want my texture to be on the skin. You can see it's already interfering with our skin tone, which was the main reason why we created this layer mask. So what I'm going to be doing here will be simple. I'm going to be hitting the command key, then selecting this mask. Then you can see it's already selected and I can turn on this layer back. Then all I just need to do here is just to add the layer mask. So now when I do that, you can see it's still affecting my image because I am revealing my image and I'm hiding the background. So now I want to reveal the background and hide my image. So what am I going to do here? All I need to do is just to hit the command I to invert this. So you can see before and after, we have our textured background well masked out on our separated easily from our subject. So now the next thing I'm going to be doing, because I did a little bit extra with this image because I wanted it to look really nice, I'm going to be doing something quite basic here. I might, because I don't want so much textures on the floor, I like to separate textures from the floor a lot. So I'm going to eat my brush to reduce the size a little bit and reduce my flow to, like, let's say 35. Let's just say 30. So, and I'm going to eat the, I think my brush has to be black here, and I'm going to paint through just to soften it a little bit. I don't want so much textures on the floor. I prefer the textures on the background layer. So the next thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to go back to my resources. I'm going to bring this abstract layer here. So now watch what I'm going to do with this. So I'm going to take this, I'm going to drop this here. Repeat the same thing, hit the shift button so it can be perfect. Then I'm going to use the alt button to enlarge it a little bit. Just a little bit. And I'm going to hit the OK button. Now you can see it's all on our subject and all that. I don't like the way it's looking right now because it's not looking like how it's meant to look like. So the next thing I'm going to do here is pretty simple. I'm going to hit on image because I don't want this color. This color looks quite confusing. It's going to make my picture look too colorful, and the colors won't be perfect at the same time, so I want to minimize this color. So what I'm going to do here will just be to hit my image adjustments and black and white straight up, and I hit the OK button. So the next thing I'm going to do here is that I also don't want this to be too harsh, so what I'm going to be doing will be simple. I'm going to hit the filter button. I want this to look like a blur, so it's not going to look too sharp the way it's looking like. So I'm going to hit the filter button, click on the blur, click on Gaussian blur, then increase it to like 8.5, then hit the OK button. Next thing I'm going to do here is just to blend it. So that's normal, take it from normal to spotlight, soft light, sorry, to soft light. So now that I have done this, I just have to repeat the same process I did for this texture. So I'm going to be hitting using the command key to make this selection from here and come here and hit the layer mask. So you can see I've separated it, right? But it doesn't look pretty nice. So all we just need to do here will just be to reduce the opacity of this to like 50%. Now you can see we are getting there gradually. It's looking pretty. Now I don't like this sharp edges I see here. So what I'm going to do is will be to hit my brush too. Leave the flow at 30, black, and can you see that? Looks pretty, right? So now, once we're done with this, all we now have to do would be to create a very much more dramatic background. So now I want to introduce my clouds to this because I want it to look pretty nice and pretty artistic. So I'm going to go back to my resource panel, click on this and bring in my clouds. Now you can see this, just going to try to reduce the size, sorry, yeah, and it's okay. So looks nice, right? But that's not what we want to use it for. Now I'm going to try my blending options and I'm going to hit this to soft light. You can see looks very much blended, but it's affecting our subject. So what are we going to do here? Going to repeat the same process, come to our layer mask here, hit the command button. You can see it's showing like it wants to pick a selection and select it. Now we come to our clouds and we create the vector and the mask, the layer mask, sorry. So now that we've done that, pretty easy from here. Now rather than for me to commit myself further into moving this and it will still be affecting my image, what I'm going to do is I'm going to separate this from my mask. So there is this link, I'm going to unlink it rather. So we're going to hit this link icon here in between the clouds and the layer mask, and we're going to disable it. So now I can easily move this around my subject. So I think I must have moved this wrongly. Sorry. Must have moved this. So I'm going to delete this. Yeah. So I'm going to come to select this again. then I would do this. Good. So we unlink. We unlink, and I'm going to take this and move it like under. You can see that looks pretty good, right? So all I'm going to do now will be to duplicate this layer again and move the clouds elsewhere. Duplicate this layer with Command J. Move this elsewhere. Duplicate this with Command J or Control J. Move this elsewhere. Duplicate this again. Create one more. Duplicate it again. And I can have this. So we could just move this a little bit. Yeah. So it doesn't look funny. Then we could take this a little bit. Yeah. So you can see this looks great already. Looks really great already. So I'm just gonna reduce the opacity of this. Reduce the opacity of this to like 70. Reduce this to like 70 as well. Yeah, reduce this. Okay, leave this. Then I can reduce this one as well to like 70. So looking pretty already, right? So now that we are done with this, the next thing we are going to be doing is that I have one other texture background that I would like to introduce, and I'm going to be bringing up there's a retro effect here. This is bringing it in. I'm going to be twisting it. I'm going to be increasing it with the same technique. Use the Alt key to take this. This up a little bit, then make this blending mode to soft light, reduce it drastically, and hit this selection with the command button, and also create the mask. So we're getting there gradually. We already basically have our background layer already. So I can see some marks here, so I'm just gonna go ahead, hit the brush tool, then follow the same procedure to clean a little bit because I don't want so much of it. So I'm also going to come here and clean a little bit of it around the edges because I don't want so much of it around the edges. So just want it a lot in the center. So I could also do this to the clouds as well because I want the focus to be in the center, very much in the center. Sorry. Oops. So I'm gonna do this. I'm also going to do it this same. I'm going to do with this. I want more focus on the center, that's why I'm actually doing this. I'm going to do this. Also going to do it this. Looks like this wants to get away. Okay, so pretty much, so that's it. And now that we've done this, we're going to be looking at what we've done, and the next thing we'll be doing now is I'm going to click on the shift button and select it to the texture and just hit the group. So we have this as our background. So there's before and there's after. So we could also reduce this to about 70%, or let's say some 85%. Yeah, that before and after, before and after. So now our image is beginning to come together. We have a nice dramatic background already. So the next thing now we're going to be doing will be to bring up our color lookup, because now I want to make our skin more like it. So we hit the adjustment panel, hit on color lookup, load 3D LUTs, and we're going to go to the same folder where we have resources, and I have my Choco LUT here that I created. So I'm going to click on open. Good. So you can see how nice this looks, but it's looking too dark. Our skin looks the way I want it to look, but let's reduce the opacity to about 40%. Yeah, so this is before and after, before and after. Looks pretty decent, right? So the next thing I'm going to do here will be my little bit of frequency distribution. So I'm going to click on the levels and I'm going to draw my shadows to about 6 or 5. Let's say 5 and draw more highlights into the image, about 230 or so. That's pretty good. So you can see we are almost getting there. And now what we're going to do will be, so I like the way this is looking, but it looks really nice, but I want it to have a little bit of vibrance. So I'm just going to come hit my vibrance panel and add some more vibrancy. Like, let's say about 20, you're about 23, let's say 25, right? Looks good. So 25. So now the next thing I'm going to do will be to merge all layers, because now I want to see my image itself. So I'm going to shift command alt E to merge all layers. So now that we're done with this, I want to have a little bit more balance in our color. So I'm going to use the color balance tool. Where is that? Yeah, from the adjustment panel. And I'm going to add up to my shadows and set my shadows to about, let's say, -9. Yeah, pretty good. Put my magenta to green to about, let's say, -3. Then the yellow should, let me add more yellows to it, -4. Be pretty good. Then we go to the highlights. Let's leave the midtones for now. Then we're going to do the same, -5. Then we can just add a little bit of yellows to it. Good. Looks pretty decent, right? So we're almost getting there gradually. And the next thing we're going to be doing will be simple. We're just going to be adding a little bit of vignette to our image. Shift command alt E. So let's come to filter, camera raw filter. We're going to go to effects, where we get our vignette, and we're going to add a little bit of vignette to it. So we can make our midpoint roundness, take it up like that, then feather like this, and we hit the OK button. So this is our before, after. So you see the dark edges, right? So I'm going to reduce this opacity to about 70%, so it doesn't look too much before and after. Finally, I want to give you that dynamic color it's meant to have to make it look very much balanced. So this looks good already, looks great already. But I like to add some little bit of a much more balanced feel to our image. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come to my panel and hit the selective color. Then I come to my reds first, add a little bit of cyan, red to the cyan aspect. Let's say -18, it's just good. Okay, that's good enough. Then I can come to my blacks, where I want to actually really work on the color itself. Then I'm only going to work with this because I want to add a little bit of blues to it. It looks pretty much like blue. -8 is okay. Then I can just, yeah. So this is before and this is our after. So guess what, we look pretty good to go from here. So I could just reduce this a little bit to about 80%, so it doesn't look too much. So this is a before, this is a after. So all I'm just going to do now will be to hit on my shift button, edited, then click on edit. So we basically brought this image from this to this. So in a nutshell, that's basically how I edited this image without Azure. Thank you so much, guys, for joining into this particular video. If you like this video, kindly hit the like button and also share so other people can come up and watch. If you've not subscribed to the channel, kindly hit the subscribe button. I'll join you again next time on the same channel. Have a wonderful time, guys.